Hi everyone. So let's start with the talk. The talk is about configuration management at its peak with Foreman. So about me, I'm Rahul Bajaj and I work at Red Hat as a software associate software engineer. And I've been working on this Foreman project for about near about a year now. So let's see, what are we going to look at today? We're going to look at, I'm going to actually introduce to the project Foreman. So does anybody already know about Foreman, this project? Anybody has heard about this project? Okay. Anybody who's not heard about this project? Not ever heard about this project? Okay. And the other people who've not raised their hand think it is crap. Okay, cool. So we're going to see what is Foreman, how it adds up to the picture, and key features and functionality of Foreman. Okay. So yeah. Before looking at Foreman, let's look at its history a bit. So how many of us already know what is Puppet? Ever heard about Puppet, not even knowing what it is? We've heard about Puppet, right? So Puppet is a configuration management tool, right? Now what configuration management tools are used for is to configure your machines, your nodes, right? So Puppet solves a great and a huge amount of problem for itself. But if you see a system's entire life cycle, right? A system's entire life cycle would consider installation, then you actually go on configuring the machine, and then you monitor the machine, right? So Puppet solves a great and a huge amount of problem by doing the initial configuration. But what about, you know, installing and updates and drift management? What about them? So Foreman is a complete life cycle management tool which looks after your installation, initial configuration, and also the monitoring of your nodes, correct? Okay, so three major functionalities of Foreman are provisioning, configuring, and monitoring, correct? So let's look at each of them. I'll just go through very fast because we don't have a lot of time. So going back to provisioning, Foreman provides all types of provisioning on bare metals or, you know, cloud. We started doing virtualization. Now we also support containers. So basically we provide provisioning for all sorts of machines. Provisioning in the sense, we do both pixie and pixieless provisioning. Pixieless provisioning, we do it in terms of, you know, image based provisioning. And we also provision virtual machines, as you've seen. And to provide DHCP, DNS, and TFTP services, we have something called as smart proxies, which we'll just see in a minute. Okay, so that's about provisioning. Foreman also, you can use any kind of configuration management tool after you provision your machine. Like once you've installed the operating system on your machine, on your server, then you can use any kind of configuration management tool to, you know, configure your nodes. Like you can, it also supports Ansible, Puppet, Chef, whatever you want to use. Next is monitoring. We support monitoring. We've recently added Prometheus, so we're supporting monitoring to like end-to-end monitoring of your systems. This is the Foreman architecture. So I spoke about smart proxies. So what are smart proxies? Smart proxies are basically, you can have one Foreman centralized server in whatever place you are right now, and say I want to serve some machines in the US, right? So what you can do is you can place a smart proxy there. Smart proxy will basically provide you services like DHCP, DNS, and TFTP server. You can use the smart proxy in any location, and you can serve your or provision your machines in that particular locations, and having one single instance of Foreman wherever you have it, like, okay. So that's how you have a smart proxy, which makes Foreman a distributed architecture altogether, which is which couples up with Puppet for provisioning, for configuration management in the second half. We also have a web user API. So Foreman has an API, and you can use or you can manage your systems in the way you want, writing your own scripts using this API. Customization. So Foreman basically has a plugin kind of an architecture. So some people like to use Foreman only for, you know, reporting. You can do that. You can, you know, plug off all the other features like provisioning, configuration management. You, if you want to use Foreman only for provisioning machines, you can, you know, plug off all the others. And so yeah, it's a plug-in architecture. API and CLI. So we also have a API, we also have a CLI, we also have a UI interface. So whatever you can do on the UI, you also have a CLI for it. So you can write your own custom scripts and use Foreman the way you want. Okay, last is So you can just check this tool out at the foreman.org. It's an open source tool, so you can the entire repository is present on GitHub. You can have access to it, and if you feel free to ask questions on Freenode on the Foreman channel, the Foreman dev channel, and you can also post your questions on community.foreman.org. Yeah, that's it. Thank you.